The same teething technical problems. We are with you live and direct this very evening, the evening of the 12th day of August in the year of our Lord 2015, with the time now standing at very close to, should I say, 17 minutes past 7 p.m. in the evening. We welcome each and every one of you wherever you are. This is your radio station. This is Radio Biafra. We are live and we are direct. As always, I will implore you, I will encourage you to please contact those around you. Tell them that the most viable, the most truthful, the most objective, the most compelling and captivating radio station is on now. And to capital off, it is live and direct. This evening, we will disseminate. This evening we shall preach. This very evening we shall enlighten. We shall bring people closer to truth, to understanding, to the knowledge of the restoration of the kingdom of heaven upon the face of the earth. Every day when we can, we preach it. It is compulsory. It is a duty, not just to man, but to the throne of grace of the Most High, Chukwuka Abiama, who liveth in heaven. Tell your friends and your family, use whatever means at your disposal. Sometimes we are given to bouts of laziness and incompetence. This evening I will ask you to jettison both. Don't be lazy. Don't be incompetent. Go on to social media. Use your telephone. Use your text facilities on any mobile phone device in your possession. You can go on BlackBerry, you can go on WhatsApp, you can also go on Twitter. I urge you to go on Facebook to tell your friends, announce it very boldly and compellingly. Let them know that we are live and direct. Let them know that this is Radio Biafra. Let them understand that man did not send us to come, that only Chukwu Okike Abiama Binigwe determined that we should come. Therefore, our gospel is not inspired by the things of the earth. It is inspired, of course, by the divinity of heaven. That is why we are here, and that is why we must preach it. It is the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth. Nobody can come to us and say that anything we are proposing, anything we are presenting, anything we are analyzing, the way we do it is falsehood. They cannot attack us on the point of principle, philosophy, and ideology. They can only come after us with frivolity, things that are irrelevant. Which passport are you using? As if passport makes any sense or any difference to anybody. When baboons and monkeys leave the zoo, they claim all manner of nationalities in order for them to be able to survive. Because if you say you're from the zoo, you become irrelevant immediately. I have written another piece, of course I have to. Because every day we philosophize. Every blessed day we reason, we think. Because we are deep thinkers. We are natural born intellectuals. As we shall do to the very useless Yoruba man, he's in our sides. He has responded to something we have said. And we are going to shred him as always. Any idiot, if you stray into our territory, we devour you with superior intellect. I tell you. You will see it coming before you, your end. But there is nothing you can do about it. Ask the enemies of this very platform what became of them. We are exceptionally formidable. If you ask the zoo police what is happening to them now in Aba, they will tell you how serious we are. The encounter we had with them at the Iguacha, they understand how serious we are, that this is IPOB, this is its mouthpiece, Radio Biafra. We propagate, we preach, we disseminate information to achieve one singular objective, the restoration of the kingdom of heaven. That kingdom of heaven is called Biafra. The weak here, of course not. We don't give a toss. Don't give a damn who you are. We preach the gospel without fear before our enemies, We preach it in a style and in a manner that even those who are deaf and dumb will be able to understand it. We explain everything to the tiniest of detail, the most basic minutiae of detail, for you to be able to understand, for you to also appreciate that our calling is not of that of man, ordained by heaven. Chukwu Okike Abiama. That is why we are here this evening, coming to you via 102.1. I need confirmation that Jenegua is with us. Let me repeat. I need confirmation this evening. Abayelsa is live on 102.1 Biafra FM. Of course, it's CHK, our own unique brand of broadcasting. This gospel is spreading. I address them today. And let me tell you, I am sorry to say, I believe that Yenagoa can even be more stronger than Iguacha. I'm telling you. Very, very powerful, I tell you. I address them today, very eager, very, very enthused. Men of intelligence, men of raw zeal to go and take back what belongs to them. They don't belong to the nonsense of resource control. It is nice to see men, able-bodied men under arms, saying that what they want is Biafra. Up and they is on for that matter. I had to address them earlier today, and believe you me, some of them sounded as if they wanted Biafra more than myself, which is something I thought I would never ever encounter in my life. Very strong. Let me assure you, this gospel is spreading everywhere. In Yenagoa this evening, we should be live and direct, but I need confirmation. I need to be inboxed the confirmation that we are live in Bayelsa. We want to tell the people of the Bayelsa that they produced an idiot in Jonathan. Jonathan is a complete idiot. Because here we preach this gospel without fear. That is why we are formidable, I tell you. We are on satellite. If you ask the Nigeria Broadcasting Commission, they will tell you. We are on one platform before now, we are on two. On two satellites. It's costing us money and then so bloody what? We are indigenous people of Biafra. There is no challenge we cannot meet head on. After all, that is how we became the most viable and the most popular radio station on the face of the earth. Bar none. Bar none. This evening we are coming to you live and direct, and this very evening I will encourage you, I will ask you once again to get your pen and paper. Having reminded you that we are on 102.1, having also told you that we are on satellite, on two channels for that very matter, not just one. Two, we are broadcasting on two. On two separate satellites in heaven. Beaming down to this very earth. Radio Biafra is on both of them. We are also online. RadioBiafra.co. One word, RadioBiafra.co. In fact, if you go to Google or any search engine right now, type in Radio Biafra Kinyagemen. We are there. You can listen to us if you want to do so. Radio Biafra is also on IPO. Welcome back, wonderful people of Biafra. We may have to endure this once or twice this very evening, but all the same, we are here trying to overcome every limitation that is possible to be thrown towards our direction. Therefore, this evening, we must continue from where we stopped by reminding everybody that Radio Biafra is online. You know we have very credible and very powerful adversaries They will do all they can to stop us. It is our duty and responsibility to ensure that they do not succeed. And that is what we are going to do this evening. Therefore, once again, I welcome you. And I will reiterate good morning, good afternoon, good evening, and good night to some of you. Those of you in the Far Eastern part of the world, we welcome you. Those in Japan, in Taiwan, in Malaysia, the ones in Hong Kong, the ones in China, those of you in Indonesia, the ones in Malaysia, the ones in Thailand, the ones also in Australia, all across that part of the universe, we welcome each and every one of you. Of course, most of them listen via our Radio Biafra app. We have Radio Biafra app on your phone. You can download it. We have it on iTunes as well. If you have an iPad, you have any laptop at all that, of course, allows you to download applications, you're more than welcome to do so. We are also on BlackBerry. To download the BlackBerry app, go to Amazon.com. If you go to Amazon, that is where you have BlackBerry apps. You will be able to find Radio Biafra there. Most of you prefer to listen to us via that very means. We also welcome you. We are also on TuneIn. If you go to TuneIn.com, download the app. Radio Biafra is also there. We are on Streamer.com. Streema. We are also on RadioForest.net. We are on RBLWorld.tv. We are on IPOB.org. Indigenous People of Biafra.org. We are also on BiafraTV.co. If you're not listening to Radio Biafra, that means you don't want to, because we have many platforms. If you cannot get through on one due to bandwidth problems and congestion, because the whole world listens to Radio Biafra, then find alternative means through which and by which you can listen to us. We are live and we are direct. The whole of humanity is listening and paying attention. And this is their radio station, especially belonging to those of us in IPOB. This is Radio Biafra. I will proceed, of course, to pray, to acknowledge the mercy, the grace, the magnificence, the benevolence, the kindness and the love of the Most High Chukwukike Abiama towards his children. And the best way for us to express our gratitude is by offering him praise and offering him every adulation. This evening will not be an exception. Therefore, as always, we pray on this very platform. We say, Our Father, who resideth in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation. Deliver us from evil. Deliver us from evil, we pray. Chukwu Abiama, we have evil around us. Ekwensuanyi na ahwanya wu Zoological Republic of Nigeria. Please put this entity of hell to shame. We are gathered this evening to listen to your word and to your gospel. We are gathered that you may bless your inheritance. We are gathered to remind you that you liveth forever and ever. Your abode is heaven, this very earth, your footstool. To remember your children and come to their rescue. To look upon our affliction, our suffering, our pain and anguish. To look at us gnashing our teeth. To see the subjugation and the degradation your children endure on a daily basis at the hands of those who don't even know you, at the hands of those who are not worthy to be called your children. That wasn't your intention for us. That was not your plan, because you wish that we shall live in peace, in harmony with progress and development. But those that surround us are today our lords and our masters, not through any device or capability of theirs, because they tried to invade us before but failed due to your grace. It is through the white man that brought Christianity with them. They gave us the Bible, they handed us over to Quran. That is exactly what they have done, precisely what is against the rule book. we ask you to please come and be merciful. Chukwa biama binigwe, come and be kind to your children. We are here waiting earnestly for this very miracle that you are performing in our time. We must also thank you for all the wonderful things you have been able to use us to accomplish and to be able to do. Because all over the world today, there is Biafra everywhere. Without your mercy, without the fortitude and the grace which you gave to IPOB, Radio Biafra, the whole world today will not know about you and who you are. As we said, the more you bless us, the more we spread your gospel, the more humanity understands who you are. The more they will know your name, the more they will come to revere it. Because as we said, through us mankind shall see the light. That is why we are Ehechua, the light of the whole world. That is why we exist. That is why we have brought light where there is darkness. That is why anywhere there is hopelessness, especially in the damnable zoological republic, we bring hope. Where there is destitution, we bring succor. Where there is homelessness, we provide shelter. Where there is anguish, we try as much as possible to bring joy. Where there is acute marginalization, we try to bring in inclusion. We have come that this gospel may nourish the souls of those without hope. They may nourish the hopes and the souls of those of them with nobody to turn to apart from thee. Don't turn us away in your anger. We have fallen short, of course, because we are sinful. We are born of flesh and we have to be. But due to your mercy, you lifted us up. You cleansed us. You made us whole once again. And we are here to preach this gospel that your name and your name alone may be praised. That Biafra will come in the end. That everything that lives on the surface of this very planet will look towards the east. And say we can see the goodness of this dear God. We can see his holiness. We can see his might and his strength. Because even if the whole world were to conspire against your creation, you are creation yourself. You will prevail against them. Come and fight for us. Because we cannot fight. Come and drive away the enemies of your children because they outnumber us. Come and restore your inheritance. Make us the guardians of your inheritance. We know who you are. We know the name that even the angels that surround you right now, what they call you. We know how they worship you. We know that very well. Chukwa Biama. At the end, only you and you alone will accept every of our prayer. Anytime we bend down on our bended knees to pray to you, anytime we lift up our hands in prayer or in praise, anytime we cry for joy or in pain and anguish because we are seeking one favor or the other before you, everything that we are today, that we were yesterday and likely to become in the future, we unremittingly and unreservedly hand over to you for your safekeeping because we are nothing without thee. I indigenous people of Biafra, Subwa, Room, Webby. Ehonan can you preach? No, them man can you? Nangosin can you preach on your mamma chinek? Gan or get it to Moe? Subwa, Room, Webby. He said, towards the end of that prayer, I had to pray in the language of heaven. You must forgive me if you didn't quite understand that. I was in communion with the angels of heaven. I will not go to see Chineke. You may not be able to understand if you're a mere mortal. We are Biafrans. We have a special affinity with the creator of the heavens and the earth. His name is Chukwu Kika Biama. Almighty, creator,
Only those who are blessed to come close to him can ever know him. That is the meaning of Chukwugikabiam, in case you don't know. The only name that angels call him in heaven. The only complete name is Chukwugikabiam. That shows how special we are. This evening we are live and direct, and I must go on to remind everybody, in case you do not know, that I am Nnamdi Kanu, the leader of indigenous people of Biafra all over this very planet Earth. I command the armies of Biafra, so also do I direct Radio Biafra. I can only do all of these things with the grace of the same Chukwugikabiam Nnamdi Kanu. Therefore, by your mercy, by your grace, O Lord of hosts, I will serve the wonderful people of Biafra diligently, honestly, never retreating in the face of any adversity, always preaching this gospel in truth without fear of anybody. Always making sure that consistently this very family all over the world understand our very simple stance and creed. We look after our own. We look after the children of the Most High. Through by blood and through makadi mama, and we kuku muchineke. True blooded Biafrans. This is your platform. This is your program. Let us preach this gospel for mankind to understand. We shall present our news headlines and accompanying news summary in line with our protocol, which we must observe. We must do so knowing fully well that we have nothing else, nobody else apart from thee. We are doing so this evening, and we are reinforcing what is now in vogue. I want to prove to the whole world, in the zoo and beyond, that Radio Biafra is compulsive listening. That Radio Biafra sets the political agenda in the zoological republic, damnable by every stretch of the imagination. I was wondering, or should I say pondering yesterday, the mind and the heart, the thinking faculty, the reasonability of the brain of a black monkey from Africa. It then dawned on me, rather miraculously, I hasten to add, that our people cannot reason. Somebody came from somewhere and created what amounted to a monstrosity and named it Niger Area. And you accepted it because you are inferior. Black people from Africa have consistently demonstrated that they are infinitely inferior to their Caucasian European counterparts, because Europeans came and defined your boundaries for you. Europeans came and told you who your relatives are, who you should be in the same country with, who you should inhabit the same geopolitical space with. You cannot do the same thing in a white man's land, but they can come to your place and create artificial countries with artificial boundaries and artificial flags. My question was therefore very simple. Are you telling me that your grandfathers, or some of you, your great-grandfather, even for some of us, our fathers who are older than the zoo called Nigeria, that they never had a country? They never existed until the white man came. Because if you accept the notion of one Nigeria, it means that you have abandoned your history, you have jettisoned who you are. My question will always remain, what was your name before the name Nigeria came into existence? What was the name before the Zoological Republic came into existence? That is who you are. The sooner you go back to it, the better for everybody. The sooner you return to your original position, the better it is for your psyche, for your prestige, and for common sense. You inhabit, or you should inculcate within your skull and your brain. These are the things we teach here.
and we must continue to teach it. This is Radio Biafra, live and direct, and Chukwukika Abiyama is of course presiding. I will bring our news headlines to you, and it is quite shocking what is happening in the zoo. A man is in court because Buhari said he wanted change, and change you're getting. It means that when they look at Buhari, people are listening to us thinking it is legal for a man to go and rape an 11-year-old little girl. Somebody has done it because they listen to Radio Biafra. They think it is the right thing that Buhari did, so they can go and do the same thing, but it is not. It's a crime against humanity, punishable by death, if you ask me. I'm telling you the truth. Punishable by death. This was exactly the same thing that was recorded today as a very old man, a great-great-grandfather, is in court over alleged rape of an 11-year-old girl. Do you know what his defense is? After all, Buhari did the same thing today. He's the president. So maybe if I rape an 11-year-old girl, I will also become a president. Unbelievable. Unbelievable. The name of them, of course, it's only Yoruba that can do this, and Hausa Fulani, Islam. Adebowale Dauda, Islamic, of course. Rapists, they are. Defiled an 11-year-old girl and is in court. His defense is that if Buhari can do it, why should I not be allowed to do the same thing? People are indeed insane. Indeed insane. Reported by Punch newspaper. Not made up, let me tell you. We must continue. Economic growth not translating to improved well-being, according to the pedophile terrorist, the Dullard of Daura, that only black people who are retarded mentally can see anything good in him. I understand that the very weak, cowardly Yoruba man called Wole Soyinka is now singing the praises of Buhari. I want to prove to you that Wole Soyinka has always been inconsistent. Inconsistency. He's never reliable. Of course, he's Yoruba. What do you expect? My Abo. As soon as Buhari came in, he's now saying Buhari is a repented man, is a changed man. What has this repented man said or done? He is telling us that economic growth not translating to improved well-being. If you are reading this garbage from outside the Zoological Republic, you would think that the zoo that the British created called Nigeria, inhabited by monkeys and baboons, that somehow they have an economy. No, they don't. They have what is called a rentier economy. There is a difference between an economy and rentier economy. Rentier economy is where you sell, it's like a banana republic, but only this time around with crude oil. You sell only one produce. And from there, you get all, you purchase everything else you're looking for, including toothpick from abroad, which is also imported. Economic growth, they are saying. My question to Buhari is that you are sounding like Ngozi Okonjo-Iweala. Which economic growth, which sector is growing? Oh, I'm sorry, maybe the fraud sector or the election tribunal sector. As I said this evening, you will now see that Radio Biafra is where they all get their news from. We tell them what to do and they do it. This evening, I will prove it to you as we go along. Buhari is talking about economic growth not translating to improved well-being. What this liar is saying, an Islamic liar for that matter, is that somehow you can convince idiots that the zoo called Nigeria has an economy that is growing. My question is, can you please give us an economic breakdown of your GDP? Tell us which sector is growing. Nobody is buying, the greatest earner you have is crude oil. Nobody is buying crude oil. You are no longer allowed to export foodstuffs to Europe for people in the diaspora that may want to buy a egusi or yam. Ghana has overtaken you on that. You don't export palm oil. Malaysia is on top. So what do you, I forgot, fraud and stealing, corruption and looting. Maybe that was what he meant. That the looting, the corruption in the zoo being perpetrated by themselves has not translated to economic well-being for the rest of the people. How can it be? You are stealing all the money. How can it therefore transform into economic well-being
It is not possible. Never ever possible, I tell you. Economic growth not translating to improved well-being, according to the Dullard of Dawa, according to the Dullard himself. We must continue. Liars and cheats, as if Nigeria has an economy. There is no economy in the zoo. They make nothing. They steal and they export all the money to foreign bank accounts. That is how useless they are. This man is talking about economy as if he understands economy. Can you tell me maybe Dangote importing rice, salt and sugar alone represents an economy? Or maybe slapping on VAT on alcohol constitutes an economy? Who knows? There is no economy in the zoo. It is collapsing whatever there is left. The only thing that sustains the zoo is those who are in the diaspora sending money via MoneyGram, Western Union, RIA, and all the rest of the money transfer agencies that you have all over the world. That dollar you are sending back is what is sustaining the zoo. That is all. Nothing more, nothing less. Economy, my foot. Where's the economy? Economic growth. People are lying. Where is the growth? In which sector? That is how you break it down. They think we are not learned. Any idiot can rise up and utter whatever rubbish. I have warned all these Yoruba, Lagos, Ibadan, Expressway newspapers. If you write rubbish, we shred it here. Before you make any pronouncements on politics or economy, you must verify your facts very well, because we will shred you. Buhari, which economy is growing? I'm asking you before the whole world to tell mankind which economy. That is how you people become liars. That is why when you present a very valid point to an animal in the zoo, they never debate that very point. Today I wrote, and quite rightly so, that I've been thinking and wondering why black people in Africa accepted the boundaries drawn up for them by white people. Why should white people come to Africa and decide who forms a country or who should be in a country and who shouldn't be? Why must you allow people that have nothing in common with you to determine your fate and your future? It just occurred to me, because black people cannot reason. And I hate it. That is why I call them baboons and monkeys. Black Africans are backwards intellectually. And unless they listen to Radio Biafra and begin to repent, unless they come here and confess their ignorance and stupidity, behold, they have no future, I tell you. The black race is dead, as useless as ever. I want you as a black African to go to Europe and try to change their boundaries. You see what they will do to you. You want war here. But you allow the white man to come and define your geopolitical space because you're daft. When our WhatsApp people read it, they couldn't debate the points being made. Hey, your mama, your papa, is you. You are traveling with Nigerian partner. No, look at the monkeys in Africa that you want me to be in the same country with. That is why they don't know the meaning of the word legislature. They don't know what lawmaking is all about through democratic process. But here we educate them. Here we teach them. South Africa is now making a mockery of the zoo called Nigeria. Do you know why? I told you that by the time animation zoo here, by the time we are finished with Nigeria, oh dear me, did I not tell you before a few weeks ago that they will be worth nothing before the world? People will look at them with derision. When you look at somebody and you say, are you a Nigerian? The person will tell you, no, I'm not. They will have no face to come out in the public and say, I am a Nigerian. And it's beginning to happen. That is what you have done, IPOB, Radio Biafra. You've done something that was impossible for anybody. Nobody can. You can't do it. Nobody can. This particular thing, we are the only, unless heaven. You cannot. I said to the zoo, you will be destroyed. The only weapon we have is the truth. Nothing more, nothing less. And today there is proof in what I'm telling you. Because right now, stolen funds is the key all over the world. South Africa is making a mockery of the zoo. Not minding that they have their own baboon in the shape of Jacob Zuma. another incompetent player. If he's a black man, what do you expect? Incompetent buffoon he is. A South African online media outfit, Mail and Guardian Africa, my goodness me, came after the zoo saying the money eaten there is bigger than the gross domestic product of 38 countries in Africa. And it's correct. Egwan Ezunoshi, the amount of money being stolen by this so-called Israeli elite politician can feed 38 countries in all of Africa. Stolen money. Egwan Ezunoshi, stolen, that is to tell you how dark, how black the minds of these people are. Very, very evil, satanic people. But I'm very glad that thanks to Radio Biafra IPOB, the whole world is now realizing, to the point that they're now making fun of the baboons and monkeys that call themselves Nigerians. I promised you that we'll destroy the zoo. It will be worth nothing. Very soon, Cameron and Obama and their associates, they will give up on the zoo. Thanks to this radio, because of Radio Biafra, everybody dealing with the zoo will abandon them. And when you're looking at Buhari, what you'll be seeing in your head is the picture of a baboon, a monkey. As you're looking at him, the picture forming in your head is that of a wild animal in Serengeti. I'm telling you, we will deal with them. Don't worry about that. This is Radio Biafra. South Africa is making fun of them, and rightfully so. Why shouldn't anybody make fun of them? They are baboons and they are monkeys. They loot, they cheat, they pillage, they steal. They rape little children. And they bank all the money abroad. Who is that person? A Nigerian politician. That's how you know them. Rogues in the Oshi. After stealing, they send policemen to go and hunt people speaking the truth. That is what I find despicable about black people. And that is even why I resent these idiots in police uniform more than anything else. They are fools. The person sending you to go and look for IPOB meeting, arrest them, shoot them, the idiots are abroad. That very fool has stolen your money, your future. Your sister or your brother who is the teacher cannot get paid. But when the same person responsible for poverty in your family sends you to go somewhere, you run somewhere looking for who to shoot. Are you not an idiot? In an honor police, in an honor army, Dara, you have no brain. The person sending you to go and look for IPOB, look for those doing Biafra, see if you can poison them. If you cannot poison them, you shoot them. He has not even paid your sister, who is the teacher, or your brother, who is a doctor, or a nurse. They have not been paid, though. The road on your street is not built, but the money to build the road on your street is in Swiss bank account somewhere, in the name of Muhammadu Buhari. But I don't blame you. Do you know why I don't blame you? As a black man or black woman in police or army, is because you are an animal. You cannot reason. Because believe you me, if you have the brain to reason, if Buhari sends you to go and shoot anybody, look for Nnamdi Kanu, he's giving me problem. You turn around and you shoot him first. The man is your problem. Anybody sending you to go and kill somebody else, that person is your problem. Turn around and shoot that person dead. That's your guy. They are the problem. They come to you with this nonsense. This Nigeria integrity. It is the duty of the army to maintain it. It's rubbish. I say nonsensical nonsense. Garbage. If it is, then Soviet Union should have been won. I know I should be affected more than most. Because, like the barrister will always say, when one is in full flight, any interruption can feel like a deadly blow. I tell you that. But we must continue. We are working for a very special group of people. We are working for those designed and born by heaven itself. The most high Chukwukike Abiama created Biafrans. I mean, the genuine ones. One day I was not those fathered by our Safolani men. We must continue. And as we continue, we ask you to pay particular attention to our gospel this very evening. Because it's carrying with it fire and brimstone, I tell you. To destroy every iniquitous human being, every plan of the enemy to try to circumvent or subvert the will of the Most High. We crush it into the dust. We do so with the truth, the whole truth and nothing but the truth. This is Radio Biafra. Welcome you back. African leaders must address problems that prompt emigration, says Cardinal Turkson. Something else he learned from Radio Biafra. This news this evening, a sizable number of them has been prepared to let you understand how formidable we are. That we preach something on this platform, the whole world listens to it. He's a cardinal. He doesn't mind that we once in a while come head to head with those being bamboozled by Europeans. European religion. And I got head to head with them sometimes. He still has spoken what he learned from Radio Biafra. I want to prove to you that this is the finest university on earth. With proof, facts, and figures. What do you think it means? We are about to shock them. For tampering with our transmission, we are about to shock the zoo. The zoo must fall, I tell you, to fall. African leaders are hopeless. Their children are dying on the way to North Africa through the desert, Sahara Desert. And they die in the Mediterranean. When they get to Europe, they are not treated like dogs. They are lower than cockroaches. And then after that, they begin to wash toilet and do security guard. People are standing up and saying, I am black, I'm proud. What makes you proud? Your children are drowning, trying to scramble into countries of people that claim they are superior to you, instead of you to try and do something to counter that. Can't you learn from Japan? Learn from them. They don't beg anybody for anything. But you know, useless African people. You know, half of us is in Saudi Arabia, half of us is in Rome, the other quarter is in Canterbury, and then Kosovo is in American Amen Pentecostal Church. We are hopeless and useless. There is no originality to Africa, no original thing about it. If you try to be, oh, you're fetish, oh, oh, they're very fetish. They are calling Chukwu Abiyama. Which deity is that? Oh, you want to believe? They don't know the meaning of Chukwu Abiyama. That is the name that even the angels in heaven call the supreme creator. They don't know. Why? Because you don't call it that thing that a white man is calling it, which is God. Do you see how useless black people are? Hey, Chineke Kuli on this yoji. This yoji. My goodness me. Black. And useless. African leaders must address problems that prompt immigration. Can they do it? The solution lies in Biafra. As I said, without Biafra, Africa is not heading anywhere. Without Biafra, without Biafra, they cannot make any headway. Without Biafra, every black man is a slave. Every black woman is a slave. Only Biafra can save you, including Alamaji Nachinama. Including Alamajiri Machinama. Only Biafra can save you, or else you are finished. Completely and utterly finished. Everywhere around the world is silent right now. Do you know why? Radio Biafra is live and direct. I'm telling you, everywhere silent. Hearing this very gospel. A gospel from heaven itself. Security operatives to monitor bank accounts of election tribunal judges. I said this evening I'm bringing you news to confirm that Radio Biafra is the most sought after radio station in the world. Because we speak the truth. This type of news headline has never come out ever in this world, in this life. For the very first time, they are going to monitor their bank account of tribunal judges. Why? Because on Radio Biafra, we told them, if your father is a judge or your mother is a judge, now is the time to prepare for holidays abroad. Because money is going to roll in from petition and counter-petition at the tribunal. They listen to Radio Biafra. Now they're implementing what we said on Radio Biafra. They are now saying that, judges, we are watching you, all of you on election tribunal, we are watching you. Without Radio Biafra, would this be possible? We are the only people to be, we go where people fear to go to. We let the whole world know that judges in the zoo are corrupt. They make most of their money once every 4 years during election tribunal. Some of these election tribunals can drag on for about 2 or 3 years.
That is how they make their money. And most of them went to Islamic legal studies school somewhere in Kano. Today they are tribunal judges. They are making money. Because, of course, and you know white people, they listen to us. They are now asking them, all those things they are saying on Radio Biafra, is it correct? Oh no, leave them, they are rebels, they are renegade, they are rascals. And the people will be telling them, but this is what they said, is it not true? Do you know the white man called them and told them to go and look at the judges going to do tribunal? And now they are coming out with a new law. Security operatives to monitor bank account of election tribunal judges. Monitoring somebody's account, is it not illegal? Is it not a breach of their privacy? But you're in a zoo. Did they sign any waiver, any confidentiality waiver before they became judges? The answer is no. But because you're baboons and monkeys, it was some idiot from somewhere near Kotangora will be poking into your bank account. But of course, they won't succeed. All you need to do is to give them some money. And they will dare to go and start building a house. Help the one foundation somewhere. People must understand how backwards Africa is. Security operative to monitor bank accounts of election tribunal judges. Why? Because Radio Biafra made it clear to the whole world. Without Radio Biafra, would this have happened? The answer is no. So stop pretending you baboons and monkeys in the zoo. You listen to Radio Biafra, you go and do exactly what we are saying. And then you come back and say, oh, why don't you want to ban them? But right now you're listening. Some of you under the bed. Some of you hiding behind your wife's wrapper to listen to Radio Biafra. Ndushi. But we are here. We never ever go away. We are live and direct. Defense headquarters condemns suicide attack in the Northeast. Is it not quite ironic that since the Dulad came in, the killing done by Boko Haram has increased, but nobody wants to talk about it. After looking, I want to ask Wole Soyinka, he talks so much rubbish. Wole Soyinka, that man, if you, listen, all, some of you are taken aback by his white beard and the Nobel Prize. You think, he's Nobel, that man talks nonsense. He hardly makes any sense. Go and listen to, if you like, sit down, listen to all Soyinka's interview. He makes no sense. If you have common sense inside you, you will know. Defense headquarters today are condemning suicide attacks in Awosa Fulani land, in Kanuri, to be precise. And somebody like Soyinka will get up and say that Buhari is doing very well. When quite clearly on the issue of security, the main reason why America rigged Buhari into office, Buhari has failed completely and totally. Completely and totally. They said once he gets in there, Boko Haram will stop. But the attack has increased, hasn't it? Can't you see it all around you? How can you see it that this man is a failure on the security front? You still come out and say that he's doing very well. That betrays who you are. When you look at, oh, is there a professor who happened there and there and there? I don't know nothing. There is nothing in their brain. I have given him a very simple test. Wole Soyinka, any day I catch you in a live debate and it will happen. After that very debate, they will strip you of your Nobel Prize. I will expose you to the world that you're a fraud, that your brain is empty. I will destroy you within 5 minutes. If I don't destroy you within 5 minutes, you know not a name. For only 5 minutes, I will deconstruct you from top to bottom using facts, figures, and evidence. Buhari is performing clearly worse than Jonathan in terms of controlling Boko Haram. But you're saying he is doing very well. Typical Yoruba speaking from both sides of the mouth. That man is nothing. I'm telling you the truth. Intellectually, he's a lightweight. He is nobody. If you sit him in front of me, within 5 minutes, you won't know him anymore. Oseba Abosso, he run away from there. I promise you. It is out of his so-called professorship that I give him 5 minutes. If not, it's only 2 minutes. Oseba, he will just wither away and die. Because he's nobody. Go back to all his interviews and see if he makes any sense. The answer is zero. He doesn't. But to you, you think he is. You begin to laugh funny. Am I here? Oh, I feel sorry for you people. Boko Haram now have a new leader, and that new leader is open for dialogue
according to Idris Deby. Very, very deceitful man, Chad president. Now, I have been warning you before. You never believe me. As I said this evening, I don't know, maybe Oge prepared all this news to convey a particular message. I don't know. But I'm getting it anyway. This is how our Fulani people operate. I told you before that they were creating radio stations, naming it Biafra, to confuse all of you. At a point, they said, oh, Radio Biafra have been jammed and closed. They have now opened a new one to channel all of you to the one that they created. Ojon Provocateur is a French phrase. Or should I say a French word? That's what it's called. They prepare somewhere for you. You are like a cattle. They hang a senior kweba, senior kweba. Oh, come, there is fire. Can you run in here? It's safe. You run, you don't know it's a cage, it's a trap. They did the same nonsense with Radio Biafra. They are now doing it Boko Haram. Boko Haram never issued a statement saying that they now have a new leader. No, they never did. It is the Chadian Awosa Fulani president who is saying so. Why? He said even the new leader is open for dialogue. So what they're doing now is to create a new Boko Haram. Oh, you don't know this. You don't know. Listen, Imam Abundu Achave, they learned these things from Europeans. That's the way they operate. Ojon Provocateur. They will make you believe that they will create the exact replica of that very thing. To catch that thing, they create the replica of it. They thought that by creating all these mushroom radio stations answering to Biafra, they can weaken Radio Biafra. I'm sure how many of you have, you know, sometimes you watch a film or you read a particular story, but you don't take it very, you don't know what it means. Have you read the book called Born Identity, B-O-U-R-N? You know, it was a series. What's the name of this Hollywood actor again that did, you know, Born Identity, Born, whatever. You know, the Born series, it was competing with James Bond, of course, but it's not. Jason Bourne is the name. What's his name again? It's not Ben Affleck. What's his chap's name? Once again, I've forgotten his name. Is it Matt Damon? I remember now. Matt Damon was the lead character in the Bourne series, B-O-U-R-N-E. I read the book myself. I've forgotten who is the author again. I've forgotten the author of the book. I read the book before I actually watched the movie. I read it when I was about to go into SBS, Iguacha, after I left secondary school. That was when I read it. I can never forget. Bourne Identity. They were trying to catch a very notorious Islamic assassin. Basically, Carlos the Jackal, if you know Carlos the Venezuelan. I think he's in a prison now somewhere in France. He was the one that led the terrorists to storm OPEC. Was it OPEC meeting in 1974? I can't remember anymore. His name is Carlos the Jackal. So the Western intelligence agency, I'm sorry to digress, but please allow me. I'm heading somewhere. The Western intelligence agencies wanted to catch Carlos the Jackal. So what they did was to create the Bourne Identity, to create the exact replica, both in terms of assassinations and everything, of Carlos the Jackal, in the hope that Carlos the Jackal will now say, who is this man replicating me? And then once he comes out, they'll take him down. Go and read the book, the original book. Forget the film. The film is a bit truncated. Go and read Bourne Identity. B-O-U-R-N-E. Bourne Identity is the very big... I'm advertising books here, don't I? Because I love to read, you see. That is what they do. Ojon Provocateur. They create your replica. And then over time, they begin to confuse people. So that anybody coming in, oh, okay, but there are also radio station, or they're also answering Biafra. So why don't we go there then? Do you know that Awosa is doing that same thing in real? Should I say they are doing it again? They have tried to defeat Boko Haram. They cannot. Bear with me this evening, please. Now what they have done is to go and create another Shekau. And then to say to the world, this new Shekau we are creating now is ready to negotiate. So that when other Boko Haram members hear it, the ones in the field, the lone wolves in the field, they'll say, okay, we are now about to negotiate. Let me put my tools down. Very simple, isn't it? That was when they were creating their fake radio stations
BVI, MFZI, Biafra 92, Biafra 24, Biafra Radio, Radio. I don't think you are. They will create your replica. So when you're looking at it, you say, okay, but it's me, oh, I'm not too sure anymore. That's what they do. That was why they created fake radio Biafras everywhere, answering Biafra, but they are fake. The same thing they have done today with Boko Haram. If Boko Haram is going to change the leadership, is it not for Boko Haram to announce it? To say, now, this is our new leader. No, but their new leader is being announced by the Chadian president for Boko Haram. And he said, they are open for dialogue. Didn't I tell you, Ndoshi? Anything I tell you is true. You may not believe it when I say it, but eventually, I am very, very confident that Chukwu Abiama's blessing is with us so much that anything we open our mouth to offer comes to pass. I'm telling you, anything we say, open our mouth and say, that thing must happen. Is it not happening now? That was how they created all those fake people. Everybody says, IPOB. Every blessed day, they have no other job. They don't do anything else. These are the people sponsored by APC Boko Haram. The same thing they have now done today is here, clear in black and white. Boko Haram now have a new leader, and that leader is open for dialogue. Who said this? Not Boko Haram, but Idris Deby, the Chad president. I told them, "Ani gugu dara kwa bache library. Mwa beke abo nyoka bache library ureki ila. I kana kwa kwa nime library." They don't know who we are. They have no idea. These people are so foolish. They have no clue as to what we are capable of. Only in a short while, one thing to okay, more in the we will shock them. We will shock them. Then they will know that this media world, they have truly lost it. They have lost it completely and totally. We are live and direct, and this is Radio Biafra, live and direct to the whole world. Mankind is listening to us. Why? Because we speak the truth. As you put it, reps to probe 5 billion police recruitment fund. Anybody would have thought that the job of the police is to catch criminals, but you don't know that in the zoo, only in the zoo, the police are actually the thieves. How undoshi? If they are not thieves, how come 5 billion of their money is missing? No, it's laughable, isn't it? If there is any criminal activity somewhere in any civilized part of the world, you will expect the police to go there to investigate. But when it comes to the zoo, it is not the police that goes to investigate. They send EFCC or ROCC or FRSC, not police. How many times have you read in the paper that the police are now investigating? The answer is zero. Once it has to do with money, police doesn't. They don't allow the zoo police to come close, because the police people are thieves. Where they'll be investigating, they're stealing their own and filling their own pockets. People don't know how backwards and criminally corrupt the zoo called Nigeria is. Police money is missing, stolen by police. How much? 5 billion naira. Imagine how many school fees that can pay. Imagine how many salaries and for how many months that can pay. Some states are going to borrow 9.7 billion to pay salaries for 4 months. One single person with his friends stole 5 billion in one go. Oh dear. The zoo at its finest. That is a place prepared for stealing. It's worship. It is a place, well, I don't know how the British conceived this, you know. I must give some credit to Lugard, you know. I don't know how he managed to do it. I don't know how Lugard managed to create a perfect country for criminals. The only place the criminality has been perfected beyond understanding of man. The zoological republic, the zoo itself. My goodness me. This is Radio Biafra, live and direct. Somebody is saying that Buhari, we don't need Igbos. And then somebody is writing and saying, Igbos don't mind. After all, I mean Igbo speaking people of Biafra. Igbo is the dominant language in Biafra land, not Biafra itself. After all, the word Biafra came from an Ezon man, a Jo, not an Igbo man. So, you know, I pray, you know, I want all these people that do this, they come, they say something, they just run away. I want to sit them down. Oh, Biafra is Igbo. I want to ask the idiot writing in Lagos, who brought the name Biafra? Was it an Igbo man? The answer is no. It was a man from Ijo. Ijo man. Oh, dear. Oh, dear me. Oh, we need to do something about this issue because Igbos have been marginalized because of Biafra. We don't want anything to do with the zoo. The word of Biafra is not an Igbo word. The reminder of who we are came from an Ijo man, and a Ijo man reminded the world as to who we are and what our name is. Don't you understand it? Hey, Ndiara, don't you get it? I don't think you do. They said Buhari don't need them. They too don't need Buhari. I mean Igbo people. Because me, I speak Igbo language and I am a Biafran. I come from a place called Afara. You put B-I in front of it, come and join. Very, very simple, isn't it? Come and join. Exposing another pedophile terrorist Buhari administration falsehood. They want them to write, below is an official press statement explaining how the loan Buhari claimed was diverted was to be expended. They live on loan. They produce nothing. They don't make... People say, oh, Innocent is a car manufacturer. No, he's not. He's a car assembly plant. He doesn't matter. Oh, dear. I know some of you will be crying now, won't you? But here we speak the truth, you see. It can be painful. But we'll preach it. The heart of Injinimoto Innocent is not fabricated in Africa. They import components from China. He assembles them together. That's what he does. I give him credit for that. You know, it's like a kit car. You know, kit car means K-I-T, kit. You know, kit car. They send you the cars in small boxes. They're Lego. You put it together. And if it's working, then you're a car manufacturer. And rightfully so. I don't want to take away any of the glory from him. He's doing very, very well. Very, very well. They tell you one thing and they do another. They are going for loans. The reason why I mention Innocent is because with a little bit of loan, like this money, 1.1 billion, if you give Innocent now 1.1 billion, he will be able to manufacture everything that his car needs to be operational or to be functional on the road. He will employ people to mold the tire using rubber. He will get people also employ them to bend the steel to the shape of the door of the car or the bonnet. He will make sure that they fabricate the glass for the windshield at the front and also the rear one, including side mirrors, including every other plastic. Do you know that the indicator, trafficator in your car is made of plastic? Do you know that any plastic company can make it? But, oh, black people from Africa. But people travel to China to import that plastic. You know your backlight. They don't hit my car. Your backlight is shattered. That thing, when you pick it up, is ordinary plastic. Which means common sense says that any plastic company can make it. But no, you need to travel to China to go and get it. And the economy is booming and they are busy collecting loans which they can only divert back to their private accounts abroad. Very sad indeed. Very, very sad indeed. We continue. I told them they are dead. The zoo is finished. The zoo is finished. I want them. Radio Biafra is the downfall of the Zoological Republic of Nigeria. Now, as soon as Radio Biafra came up, I knew that Nigeria was this gone. Is finished, is gone. Four people are dead as helicopter crashes into Lagos Lagoon. When I heard this news, I thought they were carrying Igbo chiefs going to see the Oba Akiolu, and then Oba directed them to land inside the lagoon and they died there. but that wasn't the case. Another reason why I'm bringing this news to the fore is that the National Emergency Management Agency, NEMA, ran to the place. They called the Southwest Wing. They ran to the place. When there is a helicopter crash, people may be injured. I would expect to see maybe ambulance rushing to the place, or maybe the police to cordon off the area to do some proper investigation, and air investigation, whatever, air crash investigators to go there to find out exactly what happened, recover the cockpit voice recorder in order to obviously ascertain what went wrong. Instead of the police to issue a statement, or the ambulance, or maybe the hospitals where they are, who is there to talk about it? The National Emergency Management Agency. Oh my goodness me. What happened was an accident, not a national emergency. Do you people actually know English language? Or you just, anything you see, you just name yourselves and you speak. Your name says National Emergency Management Agency, National Emergency. Helicopter crashing is very sad, that is true, because there are loss of lives, yes, regrettable and very sad, yes. But with due respect, it's not a national emergency. So what is NEMA doing there to supply bags of rice and garri? Do you know why they have things like NEMA in the zoo? It's to show you how backwards they are. Black people in the zoo. Monkeys and baboons everywhere. Monkeys and baboons everywhere. I told them, we shred them on Radio Biafra. Ezioku. Buhari's appointments, PDP is mocking us, according to APC, because I told you tonight, my news hound found only news that goes to corroborate what we preach on Radio Biafra. After we lambasted Buhari yesterday, or should I say 2 days ago, now they are saying, Buhari, please appoint a cabinet. Oh, people are watching. The world is listening. And you are making a mockery of us. Why? Because of Radio Biafra. Who else now? Did anybody complain about it? Or did anybody explain to the world the meaning of democracy the way we just did? Did anybody tell you about Montesquieu's separation of powers? Did anybody actually tell you that the judiciary, the legislature, and the executive is incomplete if you don't have ministers? You cannot have a dictatorship and then have a democracy. You are making a mockery of your own stupidity as a black person from Africa. Buhari's lack of appointments is making everybody a laughing stock, according to APC, Boko Haram, party stalwart. I told some people before that Fashola was corrupt. Oh, he's doing well. He can't even see the road he built near Onibombo. As you're going inside, he planted 4 trees, the flower. The man is as corrupt as Tinubu is. Fashola, the Yoruba man, the former Lagos State governor, is a criminal. This man stole on the last day in office $142 billion he took as loan, hoping to run for presidency at some date in the future. Yoruba, Ndoshi. These are staunch robbers, serious armed robbers, but this time with political office and political power. Anti-corruption activists are now to drag Fashola to EFCC. He launched a website, 78 million naira website scandal. 78 million. How much did myself, Uche Mefo, Barrister Mamezu, use to start Radio Biafra website? This one started his own with 78 million for image laundering. Because that is how they steal in the zoo, just like Atiku Abubakar. After Atiku Abubakar finished off Nigerian customs and stole some money as the vice president of the zoo, he launched a newspaper called Daily Independent. After Tinubu must have stolen Lagos State money and stolen money from everywhere else, as the highest ranking civilian corrupt politician of all time, he launched a paper called The Nation Newspaper to protect themselves and their image. He launched a TV station. That's what they do. Corrupt individuals launching newspapers and websites to cover up their misdeeds. and their evil acts. But unfortunately for them, we have Radio Biafra, and they cannot survive it, can they? No, never. We can't let them go. And we are continuing with our news headlines this evening. There's another man, he has spoken. Confusion trails ATM withdrawal limits. Are you sure that the CBN governor went to school? Because I am seriously having, when it will break one day, you'll be shocked. I believe that the current CBN governor must have forged his certificate, because that man has no brain in his skull. That man is not behaving like a Federal Reserve banker. He is not reasoning like an economist. He obviously does not, in his conduct, portray any knowledge of central banking of any sort. Every day he's in disarray. How can you be putting even the ATM withdrawal limit of 150, I thought was designed to stop kidnappers from marching people to the ATM and asking them to empty their accounts. Now they said they want to reduce it to 60,000 in a day, when a return flight to Abuja from Igwacha is more than 60,000. So you mean if I want to fly from Igwacha to the heart of the zoo, I take out 60,000, then that's it. I pay and then I will starve. Do you see how foolish they are? And he's a central banker. That man should be removed. He's so useless. I don't care where he comes from. You know, here we don't feel sorry for people who are so idiotic. Don't care where you come from. Central bank governor is a complete non-entity. Idiot. His animal, of course, is for the zoo. Anything he likes, he can do. But it's just that he's affecting Biafrans as well. Adversely, and he's into it. Final burial rites of the Oni of Ife, Obasiju Ade, reportedly stalled as Abubakar flees. It doesn't surprise me. You're about running away from something. It doesn't come as a surprise. They are cowards anyway. Cowardly people. When you hit them, when you try reminding a Yoruba person, how about Ilorin? How about Kwara State? Did you enjoy how, you know, I was sorrowful and he took it from you? And now, instead of an Oba of Ilorin, you have an MA of Ilorin. They will run away from the debate. They will say, you come and get your Biafra now. Let us see. We are going to starve you again. But that wasn't the point. The point was, and I repeat, are you enjoying how Awusa Fulani took Kwara from you and converted you to Islam? You feel, when I debate Europe, I floor them. I bury them completely. Some of you feel sorry for them, maybe because you were born in Lagos, born near a dustbin. There is a picture circulating of the Ziani Madueke in a hospital, in critically ill in London. But you want us, when I sent people to see your husband, he said he's a Nigerian, that you are doing very well. I told the people that I sent to go and see Alison Madueke that the wife will come back from Nigeria in disgrace. And they said that to him, very politely, of course. Today, the wife is lying down in a London hospital in disgrace. So is it not the same Nigeria you claim you love? Why is the Ziani not in a hospital in Abuja or in Igwacha? Why London? It is that type of hypocrisy I cannot stand. All of you are claiming, oh, I'm a minister, we love Nigeria, this is our nation, Nigeria. Why do all of you have to go outside for your medical treatment? You love Nigeria, but not the hospitals. Oh dear me. Look at her releasing her pictures on a sick bed in London in order to avoid public ridicule. But I told your husband, I told him, Biafra is the only solution. All of you, you will come back with shame. Look at Jonathan today. Jonathan is the object of ridicule all over the world. Even ordinary white, they tell me that man is beyond useless. Jonathan, beyond useless. Only the idiots he gave pipeline contracts to can speak good of him. And then we come to that man, that Yoruba man called Wole Soyinka, that speaks from both sides of the mouth. They call him Nobel laureate. I told you that Radio Biafra is causing havoc in the zoo. We are causing commotion, big one, and the greater one is even coming. The roadblock, what they are witnessing now is go slow. The roadblock is coming. Usoka Ochi Apochi, very shortly. Who tell them how formidable we are? I'm telling you. Pirates Confraternity isn't a cult. Remember on Radio Biafra, we accused Wole Soyinka of forming the Sea Dogs. He called them the Pirates. He said it is not a confraternity. No, it is a confraternity, but not a cult. And he did not write it the proper words, pirate with P-I. I want to point out how they deceive all of you in the zoo. Some of you don't, sometimes I don't even know why you bother going to church on a Sunday. Come to Radio Biafra, we educate you and point you to Chukwu Abiama, your creator, your maker, with no image in front of you. I'm sure now that pastors are jumping up and down saying, oh, don't say that, please, because isn't it? You know what you're preaching is a bunch of just lies and deceit. But you have to anyway, because you have to feed. And you love to have a flock, a congregation. Every Sunday you deceive them. The same thing they are doing with the zoo newspapers. Instead of writing the proper pirates, P-I-R-A-T-E-S, pirates, they wrote P-Y-R-A-T-E-S. That's Yoruba news management for you. They call it Pirates Confraternity isn't a cult, says Soyinka. Pirates Confraternity. At UNN in those days, they wear black and white. And I wear Benin or Chicha. Oh, dear me, this year, gee. Soyinka forgot one thing, that something may work in America doesn't mean it will work in Africa. Because in Africa, they are black. They turn everything upside down. In America, they use the power of incumbency to build bridges, to build roads, to formulate and articulate good policies towards education, towards industry, towards commerce, towards people's lifestyle and well-being. In Africa, an African politician sees his office as an opportunity to steal, to loot, and to pillage. The fact Americans are doing something and it's working, you copy it and you bring it to Africa, you are inviting trouble. In Africa, we are backwards mentally and intellectually. We will not understand it. That is why pirates is a cult. Who brought it in? Well, Soyinka. But when I told you that Soyinka brought in pirates, you didn't believe me, did you? You think I will sit here and lie? The seat I am sitting upon, Chukwu Abiama made it possible, not man. So I cannot lie. What, my goodness, if I tell you the truth, what will you do? You cannot do anything to me now, so I have to tell you the truth. When I told you that Wole Soyinka brought in pirates, these are the idiots responsible for the killings in the universities, because after pirates came buccaneers. Because, you know, black people, they went and read and studied the history of the piracy in the Caribbean in those days. They found out that you had pirates and you also had buccaneers as well. So the idiots, they formed buccaneers wearing yellow. Their own color is a yellow sash. The other one is black and white, this one is yellow. And I was in a university. Oh, dear me. Hey, idiocy of the highest order. This man brought cultism to universities. Wole Soyinka, Yoruba man, so-called Nobel laureate. He lacks vision. And definitely not an intellectual. If he challenges me, I can allow him to debate. After that, I'll come in. I'll go first and he can come second. I'm dumb, docile. Doesn't know anything. They use what is called Yoruba media image laundering. That was how Yoruba sold all their fake Islamic pastors to you. Every well-known Yoruba Pentecostal pastor is a Muslim. Have you ever asked yourself, how come they deceived all of you? Because of the preponderance of their media. They will go and bring out a fraudster from Islam. They wash him clean. Most of them are from Ilorin, Kwara State, the home of Yoruba Islam. Today, they are controlling all of you. Oh, dear me. Wole Soyinka is a fraud and a liar. This evening, just very lightly. That concludes our news headlines. Allow me to bring you our news in greater detail. We have not lost much time due to intermittency, so we are sticking to time. Don't worry about that. I will take your calls this evening as always. and I do not envisage any other intermittency from now till the time that we close. The news in greater detail. A septuagenarian, which means a very old man, possibly in his 80s, because they don't want to mention his name or his age. They said a septuagenarian. Now, if your school were on strike throughout the 4 years, you claim you are an undergraduate, now you've graduated and you're at NYSC camp. Let us be honest with ourselves. How many people in the zoo called Nigeria, even graduates, know the meaning of septuagenarian? How many of you? It's a very old man, possibly in his 70s, if I'm not mistaken. What did he do, and who is this man? This man is Yoruba Muslim. Every old man who is a rapist is a Muslim. Most of them are. Let me read it for you. A very old Yoruba man named Adebowale Dauda. This is from the Punch newspaper, a Yoruba paper. Please, it's not something we wrote down. We blog news, because if we write it, you won't believe us. So we just, others publish, and we give them credit for it. We don't hide it. We explain the news to you in a manner you can understand. Because if you have a newspaper now saying septuagenarian in court for alleged defiling of 11-year-old girl, believe you me, you won't know what it means. But if I tell you a very old Yoruba man raped a girl of 11 years, then you understand what I mean. That's why you need Radio Biafra. That is why all of you must support Radio. The work we are doing is invaluable. If we begin to charge money for it, all of you cannot be able to afford it. But it comes to you for free, courtesy of IPOB, of course, in the diaspora. Those of you that we have their names, because as you contribute towards Radio Biafra every blessed month, through your monthly dues, and you're supporting for the purchase of armaments and weapons through the normal channel, which I'm not allowed to speak, then we have all your names. When Biafra comes, all of you who are now lying, some people say, oh, call me Colonel, I'm Lieutenant Colonel, I'm Major. Which sector did you fight in? Oh, I was at Abagana. I came to Olo. From Olo, I was moved to Idato. From Idato, I moved to Okigwe. Okwasi, Okwasi. They never saw battle. They never saw war. What are we going to do in our case? Because you may have your doubt, oh, that is your business, but Biafra is coming. All of you who contributed in one way or the other to the resolution of Biafra financially, I mean, we are going to compile all your names the same way that your various coordinators sent in your name, the original copies. We have them. We are going to put them in glass archives, so that when some of you who are listening from under the bed right now, when you begin to lie to your grandchildren or to your children, oh, we contributed now to Biafra, your child can now go to the nearest library and go and look at those who funded Biafra. And after going through it, they will see your name is not there. And then you will try to go and bribe the attendant in the library to insert your name. We'll hang both of you. Both you and the idiot you're trying to bribe. So some of you now can be pretending, oh, we are for Biafra, you know. We have your names. A book will be written with the names of everybody who supported this very struggle financially, this very effort we're making financially. So you can't lie to your children, you see. Very clear. Very, very clear. This is a subtitle, a Yoruba man, Adebowale Dauda, raped an 11-year-old girl. This girl is 2 years older than Aisha when Buhari raped Aisha, your so-called first lady, a victim of child abuse and rape. Adebowale Dauda, who allegedly defiled or raped an 11-year-old girl, was on Wednesday arraigned before an Ikeja magistrate court. The accused is 78, I told you, septuagenarian, 70s. My neck would have won. My goodness me. The address is unknown because he's a Muslim. They sleep on the street, maybe in the mosque. He is facing charges of defilement, sexual assault, and breach of the peace. Why wasn't this same charge brought against Buhari when Buhari raped Aisha at the age of 9? I'm asking you. He was 45 then. Why wasn't this type of charge brought against Buhari then? They're in trouble, aren't they?
Very big one. I'm telling you.
The prosecutor is Sergeant Jima Isegede. He told the court that the offenses were committed on August 4th at 29 Anipupo Street, Pen Cinema Agege. That, hey, Agege, even as the name sounds, very dirty place. They call it a suburb of Lagos. If Agege is a suburb, then I don't know what a suburb looks like. One of the dirtiest places in the whole world, Agege. Can't you see how the name sounds? Very crude, crass, and very Yoruba indeed. According to Isegede, the policeman prosecuting, the accused called the victim to a lotto shop at the above address under the pretense of sending her on an errand. Remember the Islamic cleric that raped a little girl at Yanapaja? Have you forgotten? They always use some time. Come, I want to send you. Come, let me send you a message for your mama. Imagine those that are not being reported every blessed day. The abuse happening in the zoo, little children. No wonder when they grow up, they turn into prostitutes. So less prostitutes everywhere. Nigerian girls. So less prostitutes there. The shop owner does not stay there, so it is only the accused that goes there every day, and because of this, it was easy for him to carry out the act. The accused had assaulted the child 8 times and told her that she would die if she tells anyone. 11-year-old girl assaulted 8 times. Yoruba old man without honor. Yoruba Muslim. These are the people you want to be in the same country with. I know some of you say, oh, it is not just there. It is also happens in Biafra as well. If you go to, I say, how many of those cases, if it is as rampant as it is in Yoruba land, has seen the light of day? After all the police people are Hausa Fulani. They will quite gladly prosecute anybody. That tells you all you need to know. Yoruba, shameless old men, old fools, abusing little girls. This thing happened in Yanakbaja, in a mosque. They say it's an imam. Raped a little girl, and the police did nothing about it. Let's continue. The pedophile and terrorist Buhari, the sole administrator and dictator of the zoo called Nigeria, the British created zoo in Africa. People create zoos everywhere around the world. Even Serengeti, there are the wildebeest. You have crocodiles, you have zebra, you have giraffe, you have hippopotamus, you have elephants, you have hyena, quora, you have vultures, udele. All these things are there in the plains of the Serengeti. And then the British created another one. It's called Nigeria. It has Hausa Fulani in it. The pedophile terrorist Muhammadu Buhari on Wednesday regretted that the zoo's economic growth has so far not translated into commensurate improved well-being of citizens, especially the youth. Buhari made the observation in his address at the 2015 International Youth Day with the theme Youth Civic Engagement, held inside the old banquet hall of the presidential villa in Abuja. He said that the issue was of serious concern to him because the situation was forcing youth to be migrating from rural to urban areas or from the zoo to other countries in search of better opportunities. The pedophile terrorist, however, promised that his administration will do everything within its capacity to better the lots of the youth. He said it is an issue of serious concern that in the zoo, so far, economic growth has not translated into commensurate and improved social outcomes, especially for our 60 million young people who make up the majority of the population. Economic growth. My question is, the Dullard of Daura, in which sector are you experiencing this growth? Because if I watch the news this night, I can see NASDAQ, I can see the Dow Jones Industrial Index, I can see the CAC 40, which is the CAC 40 in France. I can see the DAX index you have in Frankfurt. I can see the FTSE 100 in London. I can see the movement of the stocks and the shares. I can tell you which sector is doing well, if it is in pharmaceuticals, if it is in the tobacco or wine sector. You can tell. In manufacturing.
Because there you will see the manufacturers, the district of directors, they will issue what is called the gate, what's it called? The gate receipts or whatever, the orders coming into the factories for manufactured goods. That way you can predict the trend of employment. I want to ask Buhari, which sector of the economy are you experiencing this growth? Is it in the sector of appointment of corrupt judges to go and preside over electoral tribunals? Is it in the sector of moving money abroad? Is it in the sector of I can't understand what they're talking about? Where is the growth you're talking about? That hasn't been translated into. Why do you people love lying? The economy of the zoo is shrinking. You sell only one product to make money. That product, crude oil. Nobody is buying your crude oil. Angola has overtaken you. Ghana has overtaken you. Even in Yam, Ghana is at the head of you. In palm oil, Malaysia. So which sector of the economy is growing? I'm asking you.
Oh, dear me. Maybe importation of spare parts. Who knows? I don't know. Do you see how they lie to you? These are the people you claim they are bringing change, but they are liars. Why should Buhari stand up and lie to little children, little youths? He's addressing. Why? That tells you all you need to know about them. That tells you everything you need to know about these vagabonds and evil people. Everything you need to know, I assure you. Evil men. Evil men. They are liars. Which part of the economy is growing? Which part of it? Please tell us. Oil sector? Are you not the ones complaining about the falling oil prices? Are you not a member of OPEC? You are overproducing your own quota. Is that not correct? To hold on to your market share. America no longer buys oil from you. Neither does Canada. Your greatest market now is India. Is that not correct? Oh, dear me. You can lie, but Radio Biafra is here to expose you. So all that Buhari, change. Buhari is an honest man. Buhari is a liar. Look at him lying to small children. They train them from very young to lie and to deceive people. But we are here to correct all that anomaly, all that nonsense. If you are an IPOB family member, if we catch you lying, you'll be dismissed. No second chance. We are obedient, law-abiding people, the children of heaven. We speak the truth. If we are protecting you, we know how to protect you. Never ever lie. It was say you are finished. We are not breeding young men and women to become liars of tomorrow. We want to be leaders of tomorrow, not liars of tomorrow. A South African online media outfit, Mail and Guardian Africa, came after the zoo on Tuesday, saying, that was yesterday, the money eaten in the zoo, let me quote them verbatim, the money eaten there is bigger than the gross domestic product of 38 African countries. That is when they say the money eaten, it means the money stolen by Buhari and their friends. Look at Babangida. He's a national leader and an elite icon. Look at Obasanjo. He's an elite. He's an icon. Look at Tinubu. He's a national leader, an important leader of APC. But the man is a thief. He owns an airline, First Nation Airline. Belongs to Tinubu. Tinubu, before you became governor, did you have an airline? The answer is no. How come all of a sudden you have one? Oh, dear me. The zoo. Let me continue to tell you that South Africans, the whole world listens to Radio Biafra, and they are copying everything we are saying verbatim. That means after a short while now, Wabeke will be asking the Dullard of Daura. Maybe this Nigeria I created is the bad idea after all. Why don't you stay on your own and be drinking Fura de Nunu? If the stolen funds, according to the South African news media, if the stolen funds estimated at $50 billion were a country, the online medium reported, it will be Africa's 11th biggest economy. He's saying $50 billion. You should have gone. $400 billion is in England alone. £400 billion, not dollars. $400 billion, very close to $1 trillion stolen by black men in Africa. Black African leaders
only in the zoo. Imagine when you bring in Zaire, you bring in Liberia, you bring in Sierra Leone, you bring in Gabon, you bring it everywhere. Once you see a black man as a head of state, you are looking at the embodiment of kleptomania. Is Mochi. They cannot stay without stealing. Some estimate puts the lost funds at 50 billion. My goodness me. That means that the money stolen in the zoo in 6 months, because 50 billion is what they steal in 6 months, is greater than the economy of Ghana. Greater. But isn't it funny that today Ghana exports more yam than the farmers in the zoo? That is what stealing does to you, Swoshi. That is what it does to your brain. That is exactly what it does to you. Some of you might understand it, but we do. We do. Completely and totally. South Africa is now poking fun at the zoo. They even mentioned the Nigerian National Petroleum Corporation diverted over 30 billion oil revenue since 2009. This figure, he said, was bigger than the annual production output of half of all the countries in Africa. Oh, yes, you know, it's awesome. Stolen funds from the zoo. That is why they tell you one Nigeria. When you see Yoruba newspapers like The Punch or Nation write about one Nigeria or Vanguard, we in Ogadian, the epitome of establishment. When you want supporters of corruption, you talk about the Guardian newspaper. That's the entrenched supporters of corrupt practices. After all, the man who founded it, who floated it, I think is Hebrew, made his money from corruption. So what do you expect? Now you understand, don't you? The money stolen in 6 months is greater than all the half of the entire African continent, the countries in it. The output, stolen money. After stealing, then you'll be in hospital bed in London. And how do you? I don't know. But at least our message is spreading far. The world is now beginning to understand the level of criminality and the incurable corruption in the zoo. And when you talk about all this nonsense, never ever forget that Buhari established NNPC. Don't forget Buhari was in PTF. Don't forget that this very man owns a house abroad. Don't forget Buhari imported $700 million in a suitcase carried by his ADC. Don't forget that this very man, the Dullard of Daura, controlled nothing less than 200 billion naira as the head of the Petroleum Trust Fund. Where is all that money? This man has been selling oil for the past 2.5 months. Where is the money? This man has been governing everywhere, running everything as a sole administrator and dictator with no accountability. People are scared to ask him questions. But the man is a thief. Complete and utter thief. Whiter than white and whiter than snow itself. Incorruptible. I said incorruptible before heaven and earth. We continue to disseminate this very gospel this evening. Don't worry, we shall open our lines. And I'm going to give you to educate and to enlighten. Africa's leaders must address the problem that caused so many of their people to migrate to Europe. Where did you hear that first? On Radio Biafra. He's a cleric, he said. I told you, everybody listens to us. Everybody does. According to Cardinal Peter Turkson, during a visit to his native Ghana, Cardinal Turkson, the president of the Pontifical Council for Justice and Peace, is a Roman Catholic, remarks that Africa's leaders have been all too silent at a time when thousands of their people are desperately seeking a better life abroad and dying in the process. Where did you hear that first? That African leaders are keeping quiet. On Radio Biafra, of course. Somebody, a cardinal in Rome, is even listening. We are formidable, I tell you. Very, very formidable. If you are not listening to Radio Biafra, you are ignorant. We must continue. Security operatives to monitor the bank account of judges who are in election tribunal, or electoral tribunal, however they wish to put it. as a way of identifying those who have been compromised by politicians, security agents. They won't give you their names. Just security agents. Just look at how flimsily they throw things about. Security agents will monitor which part of this, so we know who to hold responsible. They won't tell you. Ndoshi. Security agents have been detailed to monitor the bank accounts of judges handling various election petitions. Now, if judges cannot be trusted, because judges are the last bastion, they are the last line of defense between state-sponsored tyranny and the preservation of the rights of ordinary people, those not in power. So if security agents are watching judges who should be interpreting the law when somebody is caught stealing, that means that all their rulings now on all the thievery going on is meaningless. When I told the world, or when I tell you that anything we say on Radio Biafra is true, some of you doubt me. Here's another proof. All the judges are corrupt to the extent that they are now sending people to be looking into their bank accounts. If you lack confidence in your judicial system, what hope do you have anymore? I tell you, the zoo is finished. Now you know what you never knew before, don't you? Ramon Agwa. And Agwa on air. We speak the truth here. And the truth shall set everybody free. Defense headquarters condemned suicide attacks in Awosa, Fulani land. The defense headquarters on Wednesday condemned the spate of suicide attacks in, they call it Northeast. They don't want to say the name, but the name is Kanuri. We have scores of innocent lives we are lost on regular basis. But I thought you said that you have now controlled Boko Haram. They no longer strike at will, that you are now in control. Why are you complaining? The reaction, of course, is contained in a statement issued in Abuja by the acting director of information, Colonel Rabe Abubakar. No longer Oluko Lade, they have chased him away. You know that Yoruba man, that talkative Yoruba man, Oluko, Chris Oluko Lade, Army General. You studied mass communication, you're an Army General. Ndara. This one is another Awosa man, because Awosa has taken over everything. Colonel Rabe Abubakar, another Awosa man with a name that will find comfort in Saudi Arabia. We are in the same country. What is your name? My name is Tom Sochukwu Odikemene. And who is your fellow countryman? Oh, my fellow countryman is Rabe Abubakar. We're in the same country. Does that sound right to you? If this man were to travel to Iraq, or maybe to Syria, I'd say my name is Rabe Abubakar. You would say, okay, it's okay. You're a Muslim, I understand. But you're in the same country with him. His name is Rabe Abubakar. Your name is Som Tojuku, and you're in the same country. Oh dear. This statement described those perpetrating these heinous crimes as callous, barbaric, and monsters. But Buhari called them his brothers. The army is now calling them callous, barbaric, and monsters. But these are the same Boko Haram that Buhari called my brothers during Salah message a few weeks ago. Oh, have you forgotten? Because if you have forgotten, no, we have not. This is Radio Biafra. We told them that they're in trouble, didn't we? And they are in one almighty mess. I tell you, we will destroy them. Don't worry about that. It's happening already. It is crumbling every day. Do you know the zoo is on fire because of Radio Biafra? The world can see the truth. Stay there and keep feeling sorry for yourself. Am I not a black person from Africa? When I say blacks are baboons and monkeys, I don't exclude me. Every until we prove otherwise. Until Biafra comes. The day we get is the day that Biafra comes. If you turn on your tap, water will come out from mains, water works. If you switch on your light, there's electricity. Nobody's complaining of hunger or homelessness. People are meaningfully employed, not traveling to Europe to go and be washing toilet. That day, we can say we are human beings. But until then, baboons and monkeys everywhere. Boko Haram now have a new leader, according to Chad president. The Chad president is Idris Deby. He confirmed that Boko Haram have a new leader. He did not say what had happened to Abubakar Shekau, but said he had been replaced by Mahamat Dawood, who has not been heard of before. Mr. Shekau has not featured in the group's recent videos, leading to speculation that he has been killed. Mr. Deby, whose troops have been involved in battling Boko Haram, said Mr. Dawood was open to dialogue. That's how they start. They are now creating a fake Boko Haram with a fake leader to do. They will give them money to kill people, to assume that authenticity. Then they now deal with them. That's what they do. What they try to do with all those mushroom radio stations, CVI, BVI, Radio Bedroom, Germany, Upper Niger, Lower, I think Lower Niger Radio Incorporated of Biafran Board of Control, rubbish. We told them that heaven sent us, and today they are lying in the gutter, flat. We must continue. They are creating another Boko Haram to replace the original Boko Haram. Ocean Provocateur. Reps to probe 5 billion police recruitment. If the police fund is missing, then there is trouble, isn't it? That means if your money goes missing, you have no hope. If police cannot find their own money that is missing, how about you when you lose your money? The House of Representatives of the Zoo on Tuesday resolved to probe 5 billion naira police recruitment fund stolen. They appropriated the money for the 7th Assembly in 2014. To this end, the House mandated its committees on appropriation, legislative compliance, and police affairs, when constituted, to probe the matter and report back to the House for further legislative action. What they mean to say is, I cannot be here and people will steal 5 billion and we didn't get our own share. Go and tell us what happened, who stole what, and tell us what we're going to get in return. That is how they reason in the zoo. That is why they are all criminals and they are all hypocrites. Buhari don't need Igbo people. Some Igbos are saying they don't need him either. I like that. They don't need him. He's not worthy of our commentary, to be honest with you. Igbo. We must continue. Exposing another Buhari administration falsehood. Below is an official press statement explaining how the loan Buhari claimed was said was to be expended. Was B. The money. Nigeria has a profile with an additional 1.1 billion borrowed money to do so. What are these projects? The Abuja Light Rail project, which will cost $500 million. The other one is Galaxy Backbone Infrastructure Project, which will cost $100 million. Where is the Galaxy Backbone? Maybe it's in the galaxy, in the sky, where the stars are in the galaxy, Milky Way. Maybe the money is in the Milky Way, Galaxy Infrastructural Project. What is it? If I continue to explain to you how criminally minded the baboons and the monkeys in the zoo are, you will not believe me. Everything, once you are you say, I am a Nigerian, from that particular instant, that very second, you're a thief. There is a type of evil spirit that goes, the demon of kleptomania to steal will just enter inside you. You turn into a full-blown rogue. Once you're a Nigerian, you're a rogue. A criminal extraordinaire, I tell you. And it shows. It shows. Stealing money. Abuja Light Railway. Where does the money come from? They are borrowing money against oil, crude oil from Biafra land. Is there any light railway in River State? Any light railway? They said Amechi is building one. It has stopped somewhere around my one. One of my friends said, you'll be on light railway with electricity. We'll talk about. How many of you go to hotels or big buildings and you use the lift? They will tell you you're doing so at your own risk. Oh, 15th floor. And NEPA will take light. And then they'll say, there is no diesel in it. People live like animals in the zoo, I tell you. Four people are dead as helicopter crashes into Lagos Lagoon. I thought they were Igbo people before. A helicopter belonging to Bristol has crashed into a lagoon in Oworonsoke area of Lagos, the dirtiest city in the whole world, the stinking filthy city of Lagos, around 3:40 p.m. today, August 12, 2015. Very sad indeed. Very, very sad. Souls are lost. But if there are Hausa Fulani people in it and Yoruba, then good riddance to them. The National Emergency Management Agency, NEMA, spokesman is Ibrahim Farin Loye, NEMA, Emergency Management Spokesman. Not Marine Police to go and fish them out of the lagoon, but a national emergency. It's an accident. It is not an emergency. Very sad souls we are lost, of course. If there are Biafrans or maybe white people or other foreigners, I do empathize with the families. If they are Hausa, Fulani, or Yoruba, then good riddance to them. I hate them. I'll have to tell you the truth. Some are good in Yoruba land. I'm not doubting that. Some of them are good. So should I say I hate some Yoruba then? Maybe that's the best way. I can't stand them. They are thieves. And they are liars as well. They behave like they're like a parasite. You know, a leech. I'm telling you they're going to cure you. The pedophile, the sole administrator, the dictator extraordinaire, and the terrorist, Muhammadu Buhari's failure to appoint people from the southeastern region is not going down well with everybody. As Paul Ikonne, a chieftain of the APC, has stated his concern on the issue. Do you know who is Ikonne? Ikonne maybe is the son of Eze Ikonne that was singing. Buhari. When Buhari, the man that called Buhari Ikechukwu. I don't know if this is the son, Paul Ikonne. He's in APC. These are the charlatans, the scavenging Igbo idiots. How they get Etuala. That is, they without shame. When Buhari was going to Aba, to Ikonne's palace to be made Ikechukwu of Aba, it never occurred to them that this will happen. But we came on air to warn them, you will be disappointed. Today they are saying Buhari doesn't want to appoint people from the, who are you? Do you think he needs you? Of course he doesn't need you. You're a complete idiot. His name is Paul Ikonne. He's living in Wuse Zone 2 in Abuja. Wuse, Maitama, Wuse Zone 8. Mad people. But nobody's in your village, you know, Bingwa, Ndara. Lunatics everywhere. Anti-corruption activist drag Fashola, the corrupt Lagos State governor, former one, of course, to EFCC. He's a Yoruba man, he's a Muslim, that makes him a rogue. Muslims or followers of Islam make the finest looters of treasury. Go and look at all the people that have stolen so much money. They are always Muslims. All of them. They are Muslim, I should say. There's no plural, is there? It's Muslim, not Muslims. The Civil Society Network Against Corruption, a coalition of anti-corruption organizations in the zoo called Nigeria, has petitioned the Economic and Financial Crimes Commission over the questionable expenditures of the administration of Babatunde Fashola, the immediate past governor of Lagos State. In a petition dated August 10 and addressed to the EFCC chairman, the group called for the probe of the controversial 78 million naira spent on the personal website of Fashola to launder his image, so that an Igbo idiot born in Lagos near Idioroko will be saying, oh, he's a good man, he's the president. That was how they got you, by image laundering. He spent 78 million to project his own personal profile. They are calling EFCC to probe him. They should ask for EFCC to probe the loans he took before he left office. He took loans totaling 142 billion naira. Billion, not million. 142 billion. Confusion is now trailing ATM withdrawals as Godwin Emefiele. That man is not worthy to be a megad in a local bank, talk less of a branch, talk less of the a high street bank and then CBN. He is lost. No wonder he was looking like Harris Apinapi when Buhari walked in
before Buhari sent him packing back to the zoo in America. Confusion has continued to trail the daily withdrawal limit by the customers in the automated teller machines. You know, when you go abroad, you see ATM, you are happy, you want to go to cash point to take money. You know, baboons now, monkeys in Africa, they copy their own, but there's no network. Sometimes you put your card, you swallow it, and no money. Sometimes it will tell it has dispensed, giving you 60,000 naira, whereas you only took 10. And then when you go to get the money back, they will ask you to fill a form and come back in the next 2 years with your grandmother beside you. Ndara. The ATMs are not working. When they are working, they said withdrawal limit is 60,000. It is 150,000. And I'm asking MFN, how much is a return ticket from Igwocha to Abuja? So if I withdraw 60,000 and pay for my ticket, how am I supposed to feed? Lunatics everywhere. This is banking in Africa. Baboons and monkeys doing financial transactions. Very sad indeed. Give them banana and granite. Ndara. The final burial rites for the late Oni of Ife, the Yoruba man, Obasiju Ade. I think the last wife only graduated from university. I think it's about 2 years ago, is it? The last wife is less than 25 years of age, but is dead. Idiot is dead. Obasiju Ade. They said the burial rites has been stalled as the Ababaku is currently on the run. In Yoruba tradition, the Abubaku is someone who is chosen to be buried with the king. As according to customs, an Oba is never buried alone. Are you listening? Britain, are you listening? Oh, dear me. But these are the people we are in the same zoo with. You are in the same country with people don't know. You know, I feel sorry for people, you know. Oh, let's celebrate our diversity. And I'm asking Yoruba people, your diversity is that when a useless, decrepit, diseased man is dead, you have to bury somebody with him. And you claim you're Christians. You claim you are Tunde Bakare. You are TB Joshua. And I'm asking all of you going to Yoruba churches, why don't you ask your general overseer, have you condemned this Yoruba practice, this Yoruba devilish act of burying somebody with your Oni of Ife? Do you understand now? When I told you that all of you going to Yoruba churches, you are heading straight to hell. You people, I can't stand you people. All of you idiots going to Yoruba churches, you are. Your general overseer will tell you, oh, I'm Yoruba. They believe in a culture that when somebody is dead, you go and kill somebody completely innocent to bury him. And you're preaching in a common nonsense. You're preaching Bible to me. Stupid people you are for going to Yoruba Pentecostal. You are hopeless, all of you. Very hopeless people. Look at their culture. Oh, please open the book of Exodus. No, in fact, book of Amos. I said, book of Joshua. Mom, call wow. Have you paid your tithe? I'm building auditorium, Lagos, but expressway. Have you paid your tithe? Have you planted your seed? Have you watered it? Your Oba of Ife, whatever his name is, only of Ife, Oba Shijuad, is dead. You, as the general overseer, Kumiyi, do you think it is right for a living human being, innocent, to be buried alongside this baboon? Yes or no, you're a man of scripture, you claim. Pim, they will never say a word. In fact, we should compile all the names of the idiots. Hopeless people, without brain, useless to the core. Iberibun is without comparison, I tell you. In this day and age, go and all of you debating Yoruba in all their forums, ask them. Ask British people, ask Obama. Obama, do you want me to belong to a country with people you're asking me to embrace their culture? I find the Yoruba culture abhorrent. They are filthy, dirty, backstabbing people. I find their culture reprehensible.
How can you kill an innocent person to bury with a useless Yoruba man?
And you claim you are civilized. When I call you baboons and monkeys, you cry and you complain. But heaven knows I'm telling you the truth. This is Radio Biafra, 21 minutes past 9 p.m. Normally we take calls at this time, but don't worry, we shall take your calls. We are live and... After all, the whole world is listening. People don't sleep until... Somebody want me today. If Abba doesn't come on, it's on my head. I said, what am I supposed to do? We have done all we can. Everything we can, we have done it. For Abba, but Abba must speak tomorrow. We are working on it. Must speak tomorrow. See former petroleum minister Desiree Madueke lying critical ill in hospital. This is only the beginning. I will defend her, of course, being a Biafran lady, against unwarranted attacks. But I warned the husband. The man was boasting to us. Oh, my wife is in the government. Oh, don't do anything to disrupt it. Oh, I told Ojukwu not to declare Biafra, you know. Alison Madueke was one of the people that defected. They were in the Biafran Navy. They were the people that defected without firing a shot at Oguta Lake. He was a saboteur during the war. Alison Madueke was a saboteur during the war. The wife is lying critical ill in hospital. Do she? Let's continue. Nobel laureate is Professor Wole Soyinka, Yoruba man, who is believed to have co-founded Pirates Confraternity. When I told you he was the founder of Pirates, did you believe me, Sea Dogs? You didn't believe me, did you? Here you have it from Yoruba people. Soyinka spoke in an interview with Zero Tolerance, a periodic publication by the Economic and Financial Crimes Commission. He argued that belonging to a confraternity is a normal culture in colleges and not an evil cult as wrongly portrayed by ignorant persons in Nigeria. Talking about me, I am not a Nigerian, Soyinka, to start with. I was the only person to say to the whole world that you founded Pirates cult. You brought this nonsense into the universities. If your child is dead today because of cultism, Wole Soyinka is responsible for it. He brought this nonsense in. If, oh my goodness, man, I don't know, black, and then I'm sure when this UG, because of the money, I'm going to have news. Black people, do they understand what we're saying at all? If your child is dead today, in court is a black axe, white axe, pink axe, it's Soyinka. He started the whole rubbish, the whole nonsensical garbage about confraternity and cultism in schools. Let us hear his own defense to it. He's responding to what we're saying. Saying that we are ignorant. Am I ignorant, really? Let us look at the evidence. Soyinka said, everybody knows that fraternities are a normal culture in all colleges. It exists in all colleges. President Clinton was a member of a fraternity. In fact, anybody who goes to college in the United States is a member of a college fraternity. There is absolutely nothing evil or occultic about fraternity, I agree, but how about confraternity? So, because Clinton belonged to a fraternity in America where people reason like human beings, you think that baboons and monkeys can behave accordingly. There is also a law that Clinton was the president of America, and under President Clinton, the economy grew at almost the rate of, I think, about 3 to 4% every year. There was a boom under Clinton, people had employment. The fortunes of the depleting American auto industry was turned around because of the grand economic plan put in place by Clinton to turn around the fortunes of Chrysler, of General Motors, and of Ford as well, in case you're not following, because I follow such things, you see. American economy was booming under Clinton. And within the same period, there was a typical ape, I presume, or should I say, a dictator in power. If not, when was Clinton in power? Clinton was in power after Bush Senior. Reagan left office when Reagan assumed power in 1979 from Jimmy Carter. Was there for 4 years. 83 got reelected to 87. Is it 87? That is correct. 87. Bush took over from 87 to 91. 92 was Clinton. My goodness me. Clinton was in power in 92. Who was in power in the zoo in 92? Well, Abacha can 1 year work. I don't know. Another baboon importing prostitutes from China and India. And in that process, they poisoned the bastard. He died off. These are the nonsense prevalent in the zoo. That is the rubbish. That is the nonsensical garbage going on in the zoo. Because Clinton is a president, can you point to one decent president you've ever had before? The answer is zero. There is nobody. So the fact that confraternity is working in America doesn't mean it will work in the zoo. So when you brought it to the universities in the zoo and you saw cultism rising out of it, why didn't you ban it? You want to be, do you think you're white? You're a monkey from Africa. You don't know anything. Let me also explain to you. Do you know in the human body there are some bacteria you have in your intestines to help with the digestion of food? The best place for them to be is inside your intestine. There are some on your skin. You see your skin, you have. There are some bacteria on your skin feeding on things that have come to harm you. If I'm wrong, Dr. Gedo Zogwe is listening. If I'm wrong, he will correct me. Inside your gut, inside the lining of your alimentary canal, your throat, your in your stomach, your small intestine and big intestine, you have bacteria feeding on the food you have consumed to help with digestion, to help with absorption, to make sure that you don't suffer from excessive acid and all the rest of it. If you move that bacteria from the lining of your stomach to your eye, you will go blind. But the bacteria is in your body. If you move it from the walls of your intestine, you put it inside your bloodstream, you will die. The fact that something is working in America, fraternity, Beta Sigma fraternity, where they compete in terms of knowledge and intellect. You formed your own to see those you're going to pass, those you're going to intimidate, the people you want to control, Ndushi. It never worked, did it? Today you have cultism. At least he has responded to us. As I told you, they will all do eventually. Because we speak the truth. The whole truth and nothing but the truth. That concludes our epistle this evening, this very gospel that Chukwu Kikabia mandated us to preach. We have preached it. And the whole world has listened to it. Now we take your response. Now we hear what you have to say. Our lines are opened up. You are free to please call Radio Biafra if you wish to do so. Call Radio Biafra. Because now our lines are opened up. We are also on Radio Biafra 4 on Skype. I don't know if we are on WhatsApp or not. Only time will tell. But our lines are opened up, including the coordinator's line. Everywhere is ready to go. And you are free to call us. This is Radio Biafra. We are live and we are direct. The whole of humanity, as always, is of course listening. And our lines are opened up for your calls. You are free to call Radio Biafra. I am only assuming, of course, that we have transmitted live and direct this very evening. I have a caller on the line. Let us see what they have to say. No, they are not there. I thought we did. They are not there. The line just went. I thought we had somebody there. Let us go and see who is there. The caller on the phone, can you hear me?
My director, good evening, sir.
Good evening to you, my dear brother. What is your name? Where are you calling from?
My name is Igwe Charles Obinya. I am calling you from Benin. I am from Ebonyi State.
Thank you very much. Please go ahead.
My director, you are the professor of the Netherlands.
You will
leave. My director, I greet you, my director.
Thank you.
My director, I love you. My director, you are the greatest thing that has happened to the Japanese. They will not let our director escapable.
Feel and bring it here.
Thank you, director. As you always say, anything that you say has always come to fruition. Nothing has ever eluded us in this Radio Biafra that we preach all over the world. I couldn't stop laughing about the Yoruba man, a 78-year-old man who raped an 11-year-old child. And his only defense was, why, if nothing happened to the pedophilic Buhari, why should anybody question him? He is laughable. This is the kind of contraption they want Biafras to be in, where a lot of things go wrong. Nobody. And again, another problem, police money missing. I couldn't stop laughing. Police I've never money. Had an armed robber cool. police money missing. It's like an armed robber's money missing. I couldn't stop laughing. There's a lot of things in the zoo that we cannot comprehend. The only solution we keep saying here is Biafras, please, wherever you are, this is the right time to block.
Sometimes I cry for Africa. Sometimes I cry for my Africa. Because there is no future. African leaders, you must start thinking about a future of our children now. African leaders, you must thinking, because there is no time, time is too short. But you are still behaving like messenger of the slave master. You forget that we are no more slaves. Time of slavery, why came into Africa and forced our fathers to follow in them? But now that we say we are independent, because of bad leadership, because of bad management, all Africans are running from Africa into the white man land and beg them to take them as slaves. We have everything to be rich in our land, but because of corruptions, one man wanna take everything for his own. I think better be slave outside than your hometown. Oh, this is the time we must think about future, cause our children don't have any future. I'm appealing to you, African leaders.
Hey, think about future.
Think about future.
Thinking about.
Don't think about yourself. Think about the children.
Think.
All African leaders, all world, after all these riches, please. Time is too short. when you are still behaving like messenger of the slave master. You forget that we are no more slaves. Time of slavery, why came into Africa and forced our fathers to follow in them? But now that we say we are, oh yeah, na 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 na. Chukwu Okike, the immortal and invisible God. Departed from us because you are jealous, God. You told us not to bow our heads to images or any other gods. Now we have acknowledged that we have lost the way. Remove your hands from us. That is why we are suffering in this way. Oh my God, we allow money to Rubia right now. Because of that, now churches build a school. Your poor members cannot attend it. They put our sisters and brothers into slavery for money. As Christians, I think we're supposed to love one another. But what I see is below loving expression by Christian. Oh God, Father, forgive us because we have sinned against you. Oh my God. Oh, Father, forgive us, we have sinned against you. Father, forgive Biafra land. We acknowledge that we have lost the way. Oh, oh, Father, forgive us. Father, forgive us. Oh, oh, God of Biafra.
God, the God of Biafra, Daddy, we have sinned against you. Your oracle are here to ask you for forgiveness because my elder brothers that become the Archbishop, the Cardinals, they continue deceiving us. But I thank you for all that you have done because you are the light of the world, the beginning and the end. We have sinned against you. We bow our head to foreign gods. We bow our head to strange gods. That you tell us that you don't share your glory with anyone. That you are a jealous God. But Father, forgive us. We are not righteous. We have sinned against you. If we say that we have never sinned against you, we lie. Have mercy upon us. The blood of your children have been splitting around the city and towns, being used to make a caricature. Father, have mercy upon us. Our elder brothers don't tell us the truth. But now we have recognized and realized that we are in the wrong way. The British brought the Christianity to us. They don't even support any referendum of any Christian country. They don't even recognize it. The same Anglican we embrace today have passed the law of homosexual and gay. And also, so many things are happening, Father. So many things. We have recognized that we have lost the way. The God of Biafra. We know that Biafra is our religion. But nobody told us before. But now, we have recognized and we have come back to you. Build your temple for you and worship you for the rest of our life in spirit and in truth, because you are whiter than white and whiter than snow, because everything of yours is truth. Forgive us, Father, forgive us.
Father, forgive us. We have sinned against you. Father, forgive Biafra land. Chukwukike. We acknowledge that we have lost the way. Oh, Chukwukike. Oh, Father, forgive us. Chukwukike. Father, forgive us. Oh, Chukwukike. Oh, God of Biafra. Biafra, eh, Chukwukike.